Hi, folks. This is Darren with My RV Works. We're just going to jump in and start answering some of the questions that we get from people that watch our content and have questions for us. They'll leave it in the comments. Sometimes they'll shoot us an email or something like that. So that's the nature of the thing. So let's jump in. This one's coming from Tony. It involves power coming to his RV and his microwave's beeping. So he's like, his camper's plugged into shore power. We have intermittent power problem. Microwave beeps when the power goes out. No breakers are kicked. And where should we look? Okay. And so Tony, when I see that problem, I'm wondering if you've had like these little radiant heaters or something plugged into your RV, and maybe they've been consuming too much amperage. So when I see a problem like that, I don't know what kind of RV you have. I don't know that, but what would be curious to me is where that cord comes in that's connected to your shore power. Normally that's like a little quick connect or something, but there's a junction box, typically. I don't know what kind of RV you have, and knowledge may vary, but usually the shore cord is going to come into your RV, and there's a junction box in a wall, in a cabinet, behind a false wall, somewhere, there's a junction box. And then here's your service panel over here, and there's usually I don't know if you have a 30-amp or a 50-amp coach, but if it's a 30-amp, it's going to be a 10-gauge Romex. Usually that's a big orange Romex wire that's working its way. If it's a 50-amp, they go with more of an SO-type cord. But regardless, that's going to come to a junction box. So here's your shore cord, and here's your OEM coach wiring. There's a junction box right there. So when your wire is when it's intermittent like that, a lot of times I like to go there first and gain access to that. And I'm batting about 70% of the time. That's where I find the problem. Those wire nuts will melt. You might have even smelled some plastic burning smell. Maybe not. You know what? I've got some pictures. Don't hold me to it. If we throw some pictures up, you'll see them. But I'm going to see if I can find some pictures of these junction boxes that I'm talking about. And these things are just fried and melted on the inside. So, you know, that's the place I would look, Tony, is at that junction box, and see if that doesn't help where the problem might be. So let's say you find the junction box, or there's no junction box and everything's fine. What else might it be? One thing that might be interesting is prove to yourself that it's that you're getting good shore power, that it's not something way upstream that's causing a problem, that the shore power is good at all times. If it's still, you know, if I was there and I was doing the diagnosis on this, I would put my meter on that, your breaker box. I might even use a data logger to babysit it for a couple of days if this thing's intermittent, just to kind of see the power coming and going. Honestly, I might use a couple different data loggers. I might put one data logger directly on your breaker panel, and I might take another data logger and put it on your shore cord here at your RV, and take another data logger and put it over on wherever the shore power is getting plugged into, and just try to see if we can figure out what the problem is. If I only had one data logger, I'd just keep moving it along. These intermittent problems are really fun. I enjoy them. It's like solving a puzzle. And we've got all kinds of tools and toys and data loggers and meters and stuff to do that. So it's something I enjoy doing, but I'm not where you're at. So these are the things that I would go out about if I was trying to figure out your problem. Anyway, hey, Tony, hopefully this helps you. And we look forward to hearing from you. If you want to leave a comment back and let us know what you found, that would be great. So, hey, give us a thumb up, enjoy the channel, hang out with us for a while. We've got quite a few videos that you can watch and enjoy. And so this is Darren from Joyce, Washington, answering folks' questions. So happy camper, St. Mary of your works. And so until the next time, we hope you can be a happy camper too. Okay, bye.